And now the Buffalo Croquet Club 6-Wicket Invitational, August 2023. Your tournament director is Ryan Thompson. Tournament manager is Bob Gannon. Paul Neubecker is on the camera most of the time. This first one is a semifinal match. Playing red and yellow is Rich Curtis, past president of the USCA and the current chairman of the rules committee. Handicap minus 1.0, and he's a member of the New York Croquet Club in the city and the USCA Hall of Fame. We have this tournament on video the last 2 years, I think. This is court two. The camera's usually at a junction between court two and court one, so it's a new perspective. I like it. Black went in the jaws. Nice little drag roll, and with red sitting out there, that would have been a three ball break for yellow. Except it turns out that yellow is hampered by the hoop. Rich's opponent is Doug Moore, another New York Croquet Club member, minus one handicap, and the current treasurer of the USCA. Red passes. Just in case you're new to these videos, and I hope there are many of you, the scoreboard shows traditional deadness. There is none now, of course. And that column with the numbers in it is clip position.
Sorry. tell me to shut up.
Oh, no problem.
Please.
Didn't even hear you.
Nice double target, but I got to check on the speed of these lawns. This is not a shot you would take at 11 or 12 plumber. And even if blue had missed, red would have had trouble getting yellow any more than a two-ball break and some partner deadness out of it because black is effectively guarding hoop two. It's a nice three-ball break for black and only opponent deadness for blue. Red could shoot at yellow, but Rich is going to play Hamlet to Doug's Rosencrantz and see if he can't have him hoist by his own petard. Doug's thinking break to the peg, pick up red in corner one either before five or before or after two back because he'll need red for the leave. And maybe he's just thinking about his next shot, which is really what he should be doing.
Not gonna lie, that buzzing is annoying as all shit.
Big time.
And there's the croquet equivalent of a petard. Blows up, breaks all the time. This is a croquet shot, so nothing can go out of bounds. Bummer. Classical dilemma at hoop two. No rush to hoop three. The only way for him not to leave black there for red and yellow is to rotate black and attack into corner one. But the problem with that is that black is dead on blue and yellow, so it wouldn't do him much good. So he's going to take his chances. Thank you.
better fucking save this.
That pass is
I'm
going to
take the wire.
He certainly doesn't have to do that. It'll make him three ball dead with black and could have easily gone to blue, forcing yellow to get dead on red to fix the situation. So, a judgment call for sure. Pretty awesome distance control. With no real break opportunity, there's not much point in getting dead on the danger ball.
But we'll have to have a watch. Thank you.
I only slowed this down to see whether he moved yellow by hitting the hoop without roqueting it. Because if that had happened, then blue is responsible for yellow's position, and yellow might get a wire out of it because it's so stuck to the hoop. It's a little hard to see, but he is shooting at blue.
didn't need yellow.
Good.
Bob, just watch it. I mean, I'm trying to rush it, so something's sure. going to come flying. Yep.
Yellow's in corner four, so he's setting up for the hoop shot in the wire. He's shooting at blue at hoop four, and he has sort of a double target between the hoop and blue. Almost got it on the rebound. If red's still there, though, blue can use it. Yellow is for four with an 8-yarder on red from corner four, so he's afraid it'll get clean and come get him.
I didn't know if you hit black. I didn't mark it, so.
Thank you.
other.
So Rich is in the lead for the first time, trying to decide whether to give blue and black a one back clearance, but he's got a break, so it makes sense to keep going. Not exactly a drop the mic moment. And of course, now with that third deadness column all filled up, there's not much anybody can do but set up in the race to get clean first.
There's no golf.
half minutes, guys.
Okay.
It's yellow to play, and Rich is trying to figure out whether yellow is wired from blue and black. Just to be clear, you can only do this at the beginning of your turn when you want to know whether the ball you're about to play is wired or not. You can't go get a ball and check for wiring in the middle of your turn or at the end of your turn when you're trying to place the balls so they're not wired. You have to just eyeball it in that situation. This is very clearly spelled out in the AC rule book, not so much in the American rules book, but I think the understanding is it applies in American rules as well. There was no wire, so he'll just set up for red. Blue and black are both dead on yellow, so that keeps them from setting up at hoop 4 or 5. Yellow doesn't prevent black from doing this, however. Love it.
Why shocked?
Out of bounds, but I'm playing.
That's a big shot.
Now he's going to try to duplicate black's lightning strike with blue. Not quite.
Almost. Almost. That was on it. Like, I'm like, I'm going to sneak this quicker.
I haven't heard a time announcement, but we're getting pretty close to last turns. He would only say yellow to play if it was running out of time.
Yeah.
Come on!
Either yellow or blue is first and last, so I made it blue arbitrarily.
The time?
3:30.
That's what that blue shadow around the blue ball means. It's first and last turns. And a clip on the on-court deadness board can, of course, serve the same purpose. Bingo. It's his last chance, but it's not crazy. He's got yellow in corner two to help him with one back. He can kick blue over toward two back. He has a chance of taking back the lead. We cannot interfere with the game just to make a prettier video, but we may have to start giving lessons in camera awareness in the tournament instructions. And that's it. So with careful management of deadness, Rich Curtis nice win, right? Takes Doug Moore by two and moves on to the final. So give us a like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. There's more to come from Buffalo. Thanks again to our sponsors, Chris Barley, the USCA, and Don Oakley's Croquet Store. Meeting all the equipment needs from beginner to world champion.